Hello Tinxy customers, here's a quick demo on how the AC Geyzer motor switch works. This module can be installed behind your switchboard so that it's not visible. So you can connect any 3 kilowatt power device, so like you can install it with a 2-ton, up to 2-ton AC or any water heater or any motor with up to 1.5 horsepower, you should be fine. So now let's go ahead and let me give you a quick demo on how this works. So I've opened the app. Now let me turn it on. So you can assume this bulb is a heavy load device like an AC. Let me turn it off. Pretty simple, right? Now you can also use a switch to turn it on or off. Now let's say you turned on the AC or the geyser and you have moved out of the house. Now you can turn it off by using the app. Pretty cool, right? Let me show you some more features. So now you can share this device with your friends and family using their phone numbers or by email. Once you share it with them, they'll get a notification right away that a device has been shared with them. They will have to install the Tinxy app, log in using their credentials, and boom, they should be able to access it. You can also schedule the device. So let's say I want to turn on my geyser every day at 7:30 a.m. in the morning, and I want to turn it off at 10:30 a.m. in the morning when I leave for office. So this way, it's complete home automation. You don't have to control these devices. They will be turning on and off based on your preferences. Right, the last thing I would like to mention is the notification feature. If you turn this notification feature on and off, if you turn it on, then you will be getting notifications whenever any family member is accessing the device. Whenever they turn it on, you will get a notification automatically. So now let me give you a quick tour on how the wiring has to be done in case you are installing it. So first you need to do is the AC or the geyser will be connected to a switch, right? That switch can be an MCB, that switch can be a regular switch. So whatever that may be, every switch will have two points. One point would be going to the load directly. So our bulb is our load in our case. And the other wire would be a 230 volts line, live or phase wire. There are different names for that wire. This is where the current comes in. Now when you switch on the switch, the current flows from this point to this point and from this point to the load and it turns it on. So what you need to do is you need to remove these two wires, right? Remove these two wires and connect the line wire, line phase wire where the current will be flowing to this point. Just see this point. This is where you can also refer to the wiring diagram I'll be posting at the end. So the lining diagram will go here. The neutral will go in any of these two points. And the load wire, the wire which is going to the AC directly will go here in the middle, right? Remember, we have removed all the wires from the switch. Don't connect any wires to the switch yet, okay? So now, once you do that, the last wiring you need to do is you need to take the two wires from the switch. We have already done that. Take the two wires from the switch and connect it directly to the bottom part of the device. And make sure there is no 230 volts current in these two points. You should not connect neutral or phase or line to any of these two connectors. Otherwise, you will blow up the module. Please do remember that. Okay. So that's all. Now let me quickly show you how to pair the device. So I just opened up my app. Let me delete the old device. Delete. Yes, I want to delete. Okay. Now let me reset the device. So now putting a finger in this area is perfectly safe. There is no harm. Only the 230 volts is up in the front. So there is a small reset switch here besides the LED. Just press that button for 5 seconds and you will notice the LED will start blinking slowly. See, the LED has started blinking slowly. So now this means this is in the pairing mode. So first you need to do is you need to connect your phone to your Wi-Fi. I have already done that. After doing that, click on add device, click on Wi-Fi switch, Your Wi-Fi name will automatically populate. If it does not populate, it will ask you for your location permission. You need to allow the location permission for it to detect the Wi-Fi name automatically. Otherwise, you can put in the Wi-Fi name manually. So I'll put in my Wi-Fi password now. Make sure this is correct, otherwise the module will not connect, and hit connect. Now it's connecting your module to your Wi-Fi router. Now you can see the blinking has stopped now. Now I can give it any name I like. So let me give it, let me call it Wi-Fi switch. I'll call it Wi-Fi switch only. That's it. Your device is now paired. Let me switch it on. Switch it off. I can turn it on from the switch. Many of us have Google Home and Amazon Alexa in our homes, and they make our life easier. So we have integrated all our smart devices with both of them. I'll be showing you a demo with Google Home quick. So I just open up the Google Home app. Now my Google Home account is linked to my Tinxy account. That's why it's able to find the Wi-Fi switch we just paired a minute ago. Now let me just quickly turn it on. Turn it off. Or you can just say it. Turn on the Wi-Fi switch.
Sure, turning on Wi-Fi switch.
Pretty cool, right?